Hi, I'm Mike Chiata.
And I'm Nick Birch.
And these are the awards for Indie Speedrun 2012. From the 182 completed entries, 7 games were nominated by our judges to the finals, along with 3 chosen by you. Now, Yahtzee's made up his mind and chosen which deserves to go home with the $2,500 grand prize. But first up, this year's category winners. Our first award category we're calling the Score Pounder Award. These days you hear a lot about how scores don't matter to gamers, but this award recognizes a game that proves that that's just not always the case. Nominees this year are Hippo Trip, Don't Throw Your Life Away Man, and Beneath. Our winner is Don't Throw Your Life Away Man by Team Brogue Squadron. This game is about a young boy trying to outrun the sunset by digging deeper and deeper underground. Really simple, a lot of fun, great example of how to make a contained experience that's designed to be played more than once. I don't remember finding caches of gold when I was a kid playing in sand, but then again, I didn't have a blue face either.
With only 48 hours to make a game, it would be very easy to fall back on classic and possibly even boring game mechanics. That's why some of these games, with their genuinely original gameplay, stand out. The nominees are Adam, Nine Kings, and One by One. And the winner is Adam by Team Zero Polarity Bear. This flash-based game follows a scientist as he attempts to travel back in time via his time machine disguised as a grandfather clock. However, it turns out you can only jump back in small increments. Offering a new twist on the time travel paradox, you must avoid ever touching the earlier version of yourself or you will perish. It's very innovative and well worth a play. Next up is the loudest LOL category. Basically, we were looking for games that you play and couldn't help but smile. Each of these 3 games takes a different approach to humor, and they're all great. The nominees are Grief, Caesar's Day Off, and Scubasaurus. And the winner is Caesar's Day Off by Team The Fab Heebie Jeebies. With its simple gameplay, toe-tapping music, and brilliant animation, how could we not choose this fun little title? There is no one that can play this game without a huge smile across their face. Plus, with its multiple endings, it has a great replay value, as nearly 200,000 plays have already demonstrated.
Our next award is for Solid Story. Whether funny, random, serious, it takes a lot of skill to inject a working narrative into a short game, especially one made in just 48 hours. The following nominees stuck out to us for doing just that. Skinless, Beautiful Cowboy, Dissonance. And the winner is Dissonance. This game not only came up with a great premise to explain its mechanics, but followed it through all the way to the end, effortlessly blending its tale of arrogance and piety with solid gameplay all the way through. We won't spoil the plot for you, but give this one a try if you want to see just a wonderful example of weaving story with play. Next up is the Loudest WTF Award, the award that recognizes the very weirdest in concept or execution. Should just let you know, this was much harder to pick 3 games for than maybe it should have been. Seriously, a lot of you guys are really, really weird. Alright, the 3 nominees are Uncontrollable Miniature Biplane of Infinite Redemption, Odo Benis, and Bufarella and her Quinoa Mau Mau Frog Kitten. And the Loudest WTF goes to the Uncontrollable Miniature Biplane of Infinite Redemption by Team One Difference. In this game, you play as a tiny plane trapped inside of a train. All right, that's already kind of weird. And the train is filled with quote-unquote unbelievers. And the only way to save their souls is to fly into their head. Obviously.
The Sore Fingers Award is a category of games that have a tendency to just keep cranking up the pressure the more you play them. The nominees for this category are Idiosaurus, Asylum Knight, and Alphanauts. And the winner is Alphanauts by Team Neverpants. This truly original game has you utilizing all 26 letters on your keyboards, to individually move your Alphanauts and avoid ever faster appearing black holes. By the end, we promise you'll be mentally and physically exhausted, but you'll always be having fun. For coolest premise, we were looking for games that really went for something different in terms of overall concept or story. The nominees for this category are Mind Games, Knot and Dagger, and Misery Ship. And the winner is Knot and Dagger by Team Mutiny. What first seems like a simple smash and destroy game ends up being much more than that. As a Viking on a bender, you are given just 2 minutes to destroy a whole town and its cute squirrel inhabitants. But through a clever gameplay twist, you realize that in level 2, you must now repair the town and be forgiven. The amount of damage you do at the beginning directly affects how hard the game is at the end, but you don't know that until it's too late. Karma is a bitch. Great concept and great execution. Check it out.
Next up is the award for Best Scare. Either through a creepy atmosphere or a well-timed spook, these games are best played with a good pair of headphones and the lights off. Our nominees this year were Dissonance, Abby Jurassic Dark, and Idol Hunter. And the winner is Idol Hunter by 48 Hour Games, Ship 2. In this first-person iterative puzzle game, you play as a treasure hunter out to rob an ancient temple before its residents, a nasty blood cult, show up to politely ask you to leave. The building is packed with an assortment of instant death traps that might spring at any moment, making the final experience something kind of like a timed Legend of Grimrock, but with no fighting back. It's terrifying.
Hi guys, it's Gav here, or Miracle of Sound as some of you will know me. I'm here to give you my top 3 picks for the Indie Speedrun soundtracks section. Now I should start by saying that I am by no means an authority on game soundtracks, so these picks are just my favorite ones, put it that way, they're the ones that spoke to me the most. So my number 3 pick was Hard Hat Ninja, which I thought was very creative in its use of the a cappella voices. My number 2 pick was Dawnseed, which was also a beautiful little game and something I actually found the soundtrack helped to tell quite an emotional story in that game, and I really enjoyed the kind of feel of it. Almost took me back to the old days of A Link to the Past and Zelda, with the way they programmed those synths and things, so I loved Dawnseed as well. My number one pick for the soundtracks was Eternal Flight, which made wonderful use of piano and other instruments and just felt pretty epic to me, and almost at times kind of just felt like could have been from a very big game, you know. It reminded me of the Halo soundtrack in parts. So yeah, that was my number one choice, Eternal Flight, so congratulations to you guys, and well done on an amazing soundtrack.
So, finally we've got the Bruchata, a mysterious award given by the Indie Speedrun team, unique to this competition, with absolutely no explanation of the requirements to win. If you take this award, you should be proud. Probably. Our nominees this year were Alphanauts, Think Act, and Dissonance. And the 2012 holder of the Mighty Bruchata? Dissonance by Team Pixel Cows. While we may never explain why it won this award in particular, Dissonance had a great use of theme and element, a cool look, and as we mentioned earlier, a creepy, well-written story tying it all together. Dissonance, the Bruchata salutes you.
And now for the moment you've all been waiting for, the grand prize winner of the 2012 Indie Speedrun. Well, rather than have us tell you, why don't we have the man who made the pick himself, Zero Punctuation's own Yahtzee, tell you who the winner is. Yahtzee?
Hello, possums. Yahtzee Croshaw here to give my verdict of which of the 10 finalists in the Indy Speedrun deserve to take the big prize money. No pressure or anything. There were many strong entries. Soul Dad was very touching, and Caesar's Day Off made me laugh. But these were more interactive stories than games, and at the end of the day it is a game design competition, so the winner had to have engaging and innovative mechanics that fully explored the theme it was assigned, because the themes are the whole point. If you reward a decent game that doesn't use the theme very well, everyone might as well make whatever game they like and slap the theme in a text blurb somewhere. On that basis, the winner was obvious. It was the one game I wanted to go back and play a few more times once I'd tried them all, and which made of its assigned theme an innovative reward system that worked alongside an effective challenge curve to keep me surprisingly engaged right to the end. So my pick for winner is Protein Pirates. Congratulations to the developers, Abstract Games. But congratulations to everyone who entered. The real prize in a competition like this is the satisfaction of knowing you're capable of creating a game in 48 hours. That's like 3.5 games you can make in 1 week, if you're mad.